Hello, welcome to the 100th episode of Let's Play Lunar, Eternal Blue, Blind. I'm the RPG chick. In the epilogue here, still picking up remnants of our team and looking around. Sorry, my headphones are something wrong with them. They're all kind of broken. They don't sit on my head correctly, and they still functionally work. Anyway, we're going to go back to Meribia. I've looked and looked, and I don't know if I'm missing something, but there's going to be a part where we're going to have to leave the ship behind. Stinks. At least for a while. Now, here's Meribia. Go say hi to the locals and see if we can find some starlights. Did you come to Meribia to see Remus's wondrous store? Rumor has it that it's been in his family for over 900 years. You know, it's become so famous, other merchants are coming to see it. No, I didn't come for that. I don't think he's the one selling the starlights. Lumina says, maybe you can give me a few marketing tips for the Magic Guild. Is that the same guy? Or am I talking to the one behind me? Okay. Looking for a thrill? Be sure to check out Remus's new Gaga Go-Go Girls. Fresh from their Hot World Tour, now performing 3 shows nightly. Ruby says, so we stepped into some sort of Twilight Zone episode? This town is just too weird. Okay, so... yeah, Lumina doesn't have all her magic points, so... we could have done that at the ship, but I forgot. So, there you go. You know, there really was a dark god of destruction. His name was Zophar. I say was, because someone defeated him. I wonder if Master Lun had something to do with it. I bet he did. Master Lun's dojo has been very busy lately. Once word got out that a student of his saved the world, applications to his dojo increased 2,000%. Wonder who that could be. Say, did you hear the story of the hero that saved the world? Isn't it wonderful? I heard that a gambler, a dancer, a magician, and a dragon helped. Left someone out. I wish I could meet them. Ruby says, funny how these rumors get started, isn't it? I actually heard that the dragon helped the most. Hello, bar patrons. I wonder if the ads in Remus's store are true. They say that our world was saved by humans that were equipped with his goods. Lumina says, that guy, if he's a mega money hog, if I've ever seen one, he'll say anything for a buck. Cause it takes one to know one. By the way, guys, I guess I should have said, this is most probably going to be an extra long episode. I'm trying to make sure I can get Jean back and Leo, we'll see. You know, I was just getting ready to kick that Zophar's butt. Those other heroes beat me to it, though. Ruby says, you are the biggest fibber I have ever met. Master Galleon, yes, I am planning to visit his grave at Vane. I just wish he had stayed with us this time. I heard that the bandits of Tabin's Peak were actually just poor orphans. Ronforce is poor? You mean P-O-O-R? I don't think so. Ha ha ha. Those little punks are living like kings. Their place makes Neverland Ranch look like a dump. Ha, so the bandits were just little kids. That explains a lot. No wonder they didn't try to kidnap me. They're too immature to appreciate my womanly charms. I can't show up back home and admit that I didn't have the stuff to stick it out. Everyone would just laugh at me again. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, this has happened before. Last time I went away to become a Chippendales dancer, but they said I was too fat and sent me home. It was just plain humiliating. Ruby says, well, you are kind of fat. I mean, who wants to stuff money in the sticky rolls of a fatso dancer? My god, that's mean. Everybody, heek, says I'm just a worthless drunk who imagines things. But I tell you, I, heek, saw what I saw. That cad was flying. And the crazy part, that... it was that it hit turned into a kid. Freaked me out again. Ruby says, you know, that's one freaky trick I've yet to learn. I can't wait until I can freak out worthless bums all by myself. Okay, so I plan to visit Azado, and I think I have to go back to the Illusion Woods to go to Takkar, and then I have to, I'm not sure what's next, the Mystic Ruins or Carnival, and there's also the Ice Town in Zulan, and I think we visited all the towns at that point. Oh, don't forget, geez, there's that other town that's like split into two. I forget the name of it. I like playing Mari. She's so powerful, I can imagine doing almost anything. Yeah, they were in the desert. Can't remember the name of it. Of course, I want to visit there as well. That's somewhere near the carnival. I'm tired of playing Master of the Four Heroes. Want to make a new game? My friend told me about one called Doctor that sounds fun. Do you know how to play? Oh, God. You know, I'm starting to get tired of running around out here. Maybe it's time I grew up and learn some responsibility. Nah. If you don't have any new ideas for games to play, I guess I'll play Leo again. Ha! Halt there, stranger, or I'll crush you with my kung fu grip. Leo is so completely cool. I think Tunnels of Carnage has been such a success that Ramus can expand again. Maybe he can build it back into a worldwide chain like it once was. Anyone else around this, these here parts? I'm beginning to think that my husband's long nights have more to do with that sexy new girl in his office than with work. If I find her flirting with him, I'll have her lips for dinner. Doesn't sound very appetizing. So yeah, is this kind of like old home week or something? Item shoppy. Oh, right. We want the silver... The silver stars. Not the starlights. Where the hell are they selling the starlights again? Crap, I'm going to have to find out. It was like the last town. How about that? I'm not gonna bother looking for new gear. Oh, really? Should we look in here too? I heard that the student of Master Lun's defeated Zofar after a big battle. I think that Master Lun would have had an easier time, but hey, I guess we shouldn't complain, eh? After all, it was a check. Boy, I certainly hope Master Lun returns soon. He's been gone so long, I'm starting to get a little worried. Yeah, I will go check in there, but let's check these. Ever since my husband went and got kicked out of Master Lun's dojo, he's been doing nothing but sulking. I can't stand it anymore. Hey, sulker. Well, I went and signed up for lessons at Master Lun's dojo by Cracky. Trouble was, my incontinence raps kept getting in the way of my kicks. They finally told me just to leave. Continents wraps, okay. Even though Master Lun is not there, his dojo is growing more popular daily. I wonder why people still want to learn his way. Now that Lun has left Meribia, I feel much better about the town in general. I just don't get that creeping, icky feeling I got when he was around. The bandits of Taban's Peak have disappeared? Do you know what that means? Now we can get to Vayne. This is fantastic. Okay, that's Ramus's. There's one here first. The thing I like best about the Tunnels of Carnage is that it's all so real. And even better, it's different every time. Alina says, maybe we can copy it and open a mega better one in Vayne. That should pull in the crowds. I tried Ramus's new ride. What's the big deal? It's just the sewers, for God's sake. He just is letting people walk around the stinky town sewers. They've been there forever. What's so exciting about that? Really, P.T. Barnum Jr. is what that kid is. Sheesh. Ramus said that he's going to open an after-hours haunted house. He said it's going to be for adults only. I told him that I was 21, so he'd let me give the tours. Guess you're not 21? So tell me, once you marry Ramus, are you going to come to work for us? I hope so. I'd like to see you run around in some of these garments. I know you look so hot in them. Ramus is one lucky man. Talking to Lamina? I just love walking around this store dropping things on the floor. Then all you have to do is wait for one of those ladies to come and pick it up. I'm telling you, this place has answered all my prayers. Whoa, Lamina, I heard that you and the boss are going to the Chapel of Love. I hope Ramus will ask me to be his best man. Nothing to say, Lamina? Ramus is such a genius. He's taken the store and turned it into a silver mine. I've received 3 raises in the last week. I'm finally going to be a rich man. He said silver mine because there's actually no gold in this town. I hope Ramus makes this store as great as it was originally. That's when he had all the money and I could do whatever I wanted. Every day it's the same old scenario. Take people into the sewer, act lost, steal their money, and bring them out. If it wasn't for all the money I'm making, I would have quit already. Since I've started advertising this little place, business is booming. People are coming from all over just to take a 10-minute ride. Lamina, I'd like to raise the stakes on our little bet. If you rebuild the Magic Guild before I turn a profit, I'll donate all future profits to the Magic Guild. Mega cool. That's the kind of bet I would like to win. However, if I win, you will have to become my wife. After all, that's how all of the Ramus family got their beautiful wives. Heh, yeah, you bought them. I don't think I like this proposal anymore. Sorry, my little teddy bear, you already agreed to my terms.
She did?
And after all, verbal agreements are binding in Meribia. But don't worry, I'll make sure the guild gets rebuilt one way or another. I can't believe I agreed to that stupid bet. I've gotta win or I'm going to be wed to Fatty Cheeks. I don't remember her saying that she was in. She just said it sounded mega cool. It's not like I'm going to win overnight, Lamina, but I do want to marry you. It's like Dad always says, the best brides are bought brides. And I'm beginning to think he was right. Don't worry, Anus. It's not like I'm going to back out of our little bet. Lamina, you were starting to like me. And you've already given me a pet name. Dad said if you give them enough time, they'll grow to love you. Phew, I don't love you, and I don't intend to lose. I'll be back to get my money. Hello, my darling angel. Is everything going all right with you? Hello, Anus. Don't start gloating yet. You still haven't won. Ruby says, I don't see you trying to win the bet, Lamina. Maybe you secretly long to be Ramus's wife. Hill Arius. Okay, let's check down here and then we'll go inside the dojo, I guess. Ever since Zophar was defeated, this place has become Partyville. You know, if I didn't know better, I'd think this month was some sort of holiday. Master Lun said he was going to Horum to make his karate stronger. Man, I wish I was as cool as him. Now that side that we're looking at, we can't get to, right? Yeah, they cheated us. Half of Meribia is inaccessible. Yep, okay, let's check out in here. So we're not getting the lights then. Silver lights, because they're not here. I'll check out a few people, see if they have anything different to say. People say that you should learn karate for self-defense. And why is it we spend so much time on offensive maneuvers? I'm sorry, but Master Lun still hasn't returned to Meribia. He's probably off saving the world from evil. Lun is just a great guy. Oh, these are the guys that zip around. I've heard the bandits of Taban's Peak have enlisted children to fight for them. What kind of sick person would cause children to fight in a war? Ruby says, evidently a really sick one. Lun left me in charge of their training. I have to make sure that these guys practice at least 18 hours every day. I've begun to work with a voice coach. Listen to this. Hi-ya! You know, I don't think these guys have anything new to say. Okay, let's be on our way. We've got lots more places to visit. Okay, I don't want to go in there. Just want to pay a quick visit to Azado. Well, as quick as we can make it anyway. That's a dead end. What is this place again? Oh, well, here's Veen. Okay, so we gotta continue south. South-ish from here. Kasploosh. Here we are. Hello. These tourists are starting to annoy the hell out of me. Always asking questions. Where's the tower? Where's the tower? Geez, just look up for God's sakes. It's the tallest thing here. Man, I hate dealing with the public. Whew, for a while there I was totally insane. I'm glad I got my sanity back just in time to hear about Leo's victory. I couldn't believe it. There he was, all alone. Evil surrounded him. Nowhere to run. Nowhere to hide. But Leo fearlessly thrust his saber into Zophar's black heart. Talk about brave. Wow. The carpenter was just here. He said he's going to cut me a deal on materials. And I just signed the loan papers today. It's only going to be a 45-year loan. Mazel tov. Good news. My boss told me that if you decide to buy right now, we'll put in all new energy-saving double-paned windows. What do you say? I don't believe it. Leo killed the beast and didn't even stop by to tell me. That's a man for you. They do their job and you never hear from them again. I see you destroyed Zophar without using my special beads. You could have defeated them in half the time if you weren't such a cheapo. Ruby says, your beads are about as useless as Lamina's guild memberships. Ronfuss says, hey Ruby, that's no call for picking on the little lady. At least she's a go-getter. That's funny. The kids now seem like they are happy, but I don't think anything will be able to erase their pain. I don't remember where their pain is from. I want you to look at me and say, the monster was only doing his job. He didn't hate me, he's just a victim, just like me. There, now. Don't you feel better? I know I do. 1,000 silver, please. I wish I could have watched you kill the beast. I would have liked to have seen that thing cut into a zillion pieces. Hmm. My fiancé and I are going to be married next week. We're going to take our honeymoon in the carnival on the Meribia Plains. That's where I want to go. That's where Jean is. Guess what? I just decided to take a vacation and tie the knot. I just can't live without her. Nothing was ever going to come between us again. Well, congratulations to you. I've had enough of these priests and their noble causes. I draw the line when one of them asks me to donate so his dog can have a facelift. Yeah, seen that one. I'm going to back to school so I can learn about our history. The Blue Star, the Goddess, dragons, and heroic dragon masters. I need to learn more about all of this. Maybe some of it is true. I must know, because only by understanding the past can I build a bright future. What do you know? Ruby says. Dinglenut found a brain. I've decided to start making cookies in the shape of the beast. I'm going to call them beasties. If this catches on, I'm going to be filthy rich. Ruby says, why not make them with laxative chips instead and call them bowel beasties? You can sell them to people that are bound up. Now there's a gold mine. Hey, I thought there was no gold in this world. The silver mine. The sounds have stopped and the night is now silent. We owe this all to the great Lord Leo. He is truly a gift from Althena. I forgot how much these people worship Leo. Ooh, ah, could you come back later? I've been partying all night. We've all started a new nightclub. Mornings are hellish for me now. I don't think anyone can capture the true essence of manliness like Leo. He has an unspoken power that just pulls me in. Brother. This time my husband is going to have to change his ways. We just found out that I'm pregnant with our first child. If Leo ever comes here, I think he should buy us all free drinks. After all, he is the leader of Althena's guard. This time I mean it. I'm definitely going to turn my life around. I know, it sounds like another pitiful drunk's redemption speech, but this time I mean it. I'm tired of sitting here all day and night. My butt's so big I have to use two stools. Ruby says, about time you noticed the lard in your shorts.
Jeez.
I think I'm going to start a new faith, one that the people will like. People just don't care about serving a fake goddess, and I don't blame them. Sheesh, I just heard that Mari and her good-for-nothing lover just got back together. Man, my life just sucks. What the hell does that have to do with you? I think it would be so great to be a famous leader of Althena's cult, but that's only a dream. You know, for the last 15 minutes that guy's been staring at me. I think I may have just found my date for tonight. Lord Leo hasn't been seen since he defeated Zophar. I think he went off to a quiet place to find himself. I heard that the four heroes have gone their own way, and that Althena herself is no more. But the best rumor is that Black Wizard Borgin is going to take a bride. Pooh, Lumina says, over my dead body. There's no chance I'm going to be that fat turd's stepdaughter. Shops, okay. Oh, I don't want to go in there. Yep. I heard that Zophar was defeated by mere mortals. I didn't think humans possessed such a power. Well, guess again, Ruby says. The Dragon Master is not a god, but merely a human with extraordinary power. I don't think they're selling starlights there. Lord Leo isn't the White Knight anymore. That doesn't matter, though. I'm still gonna grow up and be just like him. People will read how Leo and me saved the world. I'll be just as famous as Leo. Cool, huh? No. This just really pisses me off. I finally get those damn beads, and the monster attacks stop. Just my luck. Is there anyone to talk to across the bridge here? Oh yeah. Congratulate me. I've renounced the ways of the cult. That Althina was so fake. I should have known better. I had no idea that I was promoting the teachings of Zophar. I should have been promoting the teachings of Althina. Huh. I don't remember ever selling any beads for profit. You should know that a true priest of Althina would never do that. It seems we've strayed from Althina's original teachings. I don't know if we'll ever find our way back. Well, I'll find my way back. I'm going this way. Have you been in everywhere? Have we talked to all the people and gone in all the houses? Bad enough what you said the first time. See ya. Okay. Say it like this. Oh, crying. can we go this way now? Now I'm looking for Dalton, which I hopefully we'll find. Is that it? The illusion words. Ah, back in the damn ship. Okay, can't even get out now. Yeah, unfortunately, this is the part where I have to leave the ship behind, so I can't get out here. Okay. Now, since we've already been through here. Oh, hi. I've quit my little gambling habit and decided to become a guide for these woods. Bonfar says, sounds like you'd be holding on to a lot more of your money now, buddy. Ha ha ha. Okay, can we tell now, like... I hate this crap. These things are doomed. Albino baboons. There's goblins around here, right? Unfortunately, I don't know any other way to get to the circus other than to go backwards through the mystic ruins, and I don't want to mess around with that. Yeah, those goblins. I wonder how much trouble we had with them. They would call other goblins, and we would get our butts handed to us. Hmm. pretty much always has a chest next to it, I remember. You mean we... There's a chest we haven't opened? Holy crap. I don't know how to get to it. Guess in this one? Or am I just repeating myself? I think I am repeating myself. Find my way out of here. I don't know. I keep choosing. I thought it was the ones with the chest next to them. Or maybe I'm choosing the wrong path in those. I don't know. Yeah, I've been here. Let's go around. Not go up. Let's go down. Not go up. This way. Start going up there. Trap this way. Come from this one, right? Oh, I went out. Come on. I might just cut this whole freaking segment out. It's getting ridiculous. Oh, maybe I'll leave it in. This is where the troop was, right? And this is the way out? Awesome. Unfortunately, they make it so you have to go out that way. There might be another way, but it's pretty difficult. And this should be Takkar. Remember Takkar? Let's heal Lumina's 1 point. Most of the people that come through Takkar are looking to get rich. You know, it's amazing. The more people care about each other, the more they fight. It seems to be some sort of unwritten law. Take, for example, that couple over there. They love each other, but they've been bickering ever since they got here. Ruby says, that's not always true. Nala and I fight all the time, and we don't... Never mind. See? This reaction, you never would have seen because we hadn't even met Nala yet. And, we certainly didn't have any feelings for Nala. Like she pretends not to now. I don't know why I ever listened to you, Harold. I knew this trip was a bad idea from the moment you asked me to go. Boy, this is the last time I ever suggest a trip like this. Believe me, I've learned my lesson. I've saved lots of money to get into the guild when I get big, but I still don't have enough to join yet. Amina says, well, why don't you give it to me so I can keep it safe for you? Mm-hmm. Now that the world is at peace once again, business is up 500% over last year. I'm thinking of expanding the hotel. Isn't that great? Isn't this great? The inn is very popular with the traveling merchants in the area. They all like to stay here when they have business in Takkar. I think they like the view. Now that we've conquered the market in this area, we're thinking of expansion. If the franchise deal goes through, there'll be a bounteous babe inn at every village in the world. Then, when we're stinking rich, we can devote our time to the women's movement. Don't you think men demean women terribly these days? Oh my god. That's like a feminist working at Hooters. Now that the world is at peace, the only tempest that remains is in my heart. My love for the woman over there goes unnoticed. She doesn't even know I'm alive. To love and have not is torturing my weary soul. I decided to stay here a while longer to try to get to know the women here. You think I have a chance with the younger of the two chicks that own this joint? She's pretty hot, huh? And Ruby says, you're pretty cold. And stinky. Here's a dime. Buy a clue. Which one's the younger one? I can't tell. Why? Stop bugging me, lady. I almost had forgotten about that cockamamie trial at the manor, and you show up. Well, I can give you one more chance to pass a magic trial. No, just leave me alone. Now that there's peace in the land, my son seems to be getting better. I'm so thankful. I don't know how much more of his whining I could take. The hooded girl from the Ghost Manor is rumored to be the premier of the Magic Guild. But if she is the premier, she wouldn't do something like that, would she? Lamina says, I'm sure she had her reasons. I guess the money grubber's premier saved the world, didn't she? Maybe my opinion of her was misguided. That's Magic Guild, not money grubbers. Excuse me. Are you sure you're the premier of the Magic Guild? The vain Magic Guild? Of course I am. How many times do I have to tell you? You should be able to see it just by observing my mastery of complicated magic. Well, my voice, guys. And my impeccable social graces. Okay, that's the item shop. Let's check in here. One thing about this is a lot of inns. The followers of Goddess Althena have changed dramatically. Now they enjoy song and dance. In fact, they're starting some festivals. Oh, that was him saying that. Okay, never mind. Now that the world is safe again, I better clean up my act. Ha ha ha. Anyone start a local chapter of AA? Now that the world is at peace, I was thinking about settling down here. I mean, the location's nice, and whoa, did you see the Bounteous Babe Hotel? We're talking some righteous bounty. Yeah, I could live here. Now that the world is safe again, sales of flowers and champagne are up. Fortunately, I saw it coming and stocked up. I'm making a killing. Cheers to Hero. I heard there was a way to get back to the Blue Star. It's in some tower. Ah, what a romantic notion. Traveling to the Blue Star. Oh! If only that dream could come true. Ruby says, I'm sure it will come true if you're a dreamer like Hero. Oh, we can't go in. Oh, can't go through there either. we can get around this way, if I remember right. And there's no one there. Alright. Yeah, the simple life's the best life. I heard that the monsters were made by the Magic Guild. I wonder who started that ridiculous rumor. Ruby says, I think it was Lamina. It was not, you little flying stain. We were following the wrong path. Goddess Althina would not be so money-hungry. It was our own selfish desire that led us to ask for so many donations. No kidding. Now that you have shown the error of our ways, we are humbled before the village. The people look upon us very suspiciously. I hope we can regain their trust. Don't you want to keep this shrine this beautiful? Well then, you better donate to Goddess Althina. Okay, this guy didn't learn the lesson. Now I know that Althina, Goddess of Beauty and Love, wouldn't punish us. Who started that doctrine? Seems like nonsense now. Now I understand the true teachings of Althina. She wants all of us to enjoy life by singing and dancing to lift our spirits. Singing and dancing, huh? The donation you give is not as important as the prayer you pray, but the minimum is 1,000 silver. God. Okay, let's get out of here. My. How you kids have grown since the last time you were here. Seems like that was just yesterday. Ruby says, that's probably because you're getting senile as you approach middle age. Oh, wow. One more place to check. The inn is cheap and quite clean. If I'm going to make my dream come true, I have to save where I can. Lamina says, I'm pretty sure Ramus and Ramus Jr. of Meribia are the most successful. It's going to be tough to beat them. My inn offers the best service at the lowest price. Try us out sometime. I'm sorry, the game does not give me that option. So we can actually leave now. Now that the danger has passed, the gate is open for all to use. Ruby says, you turn awfully helpful all of a sudden. Are you the same gatekeeper? Alright, what's this? Alright. We might have to go around that, I'm not sure. Let's save here. Just in case, I don't know. I don't know if I can go around this way. Well, maybe I can. Like totally demolished. They didn't even have time to scream. See, I'm not sure if this is the right way. Carnival. Oh, there's a giant gear thing. Okay. So we're at This is the place I forget the name of. Come, come, the wonders of our village await the curious. You can find virtually anything you desire in our prosperous town. Anything, Lamina says? Oh, poo, you're exaggerating, I'm sure. If human power can save our world, why do we need the shrines? This is a very confusing time to be alive. Welcome to the Shrine of Althina. We are always open for donations. Ruby says, Hero, get away from this guy. All he wants is to pick your pocket. Ah, child, I understand your concern, but I assure you that I have changed. Then why is your hand out? Oh, sorry. It's an old habit. You know what they say about old habits dying hard and all that. It's so sad that the Knights of Althina turned out to be a fraud. I can't believe how much money I gave to those jerks. Turns out that they were serving a false Althina. I should have known. Since we stopped strong-arming the people for donations, we've received very little. Our big new shrine may have to wait. I used to think that all that mattered was making our big shrine. Now I know that we should concentrate on spreading the true teachings of Althina. I believe that the power of the human spirit is truly amazing. Althina herself could not have accomplished what you did any better. Why, thank you. Oh, there's this place around here. It's like a hidden place, right? Well, hello again. Say, I got to thinking about what you did for me and I thought of this. I think we're going to rename the red wine Hero Special Reserve in your honor. What do you think? Is that neat or what? I think it's neato. If my dad's plan comes through, he'll be able to stay in Nota all the time. Nota. That's where we went. I'm just writing it down. Let's actually write it down so I can read it. There you go. I sure hope that happens. Ruby says, call me Daffy. Call me a hopeless sentimental. I think everything will be okay. Besides, I looked ahead in the script. My god, breaking the fourth wall. Being the wife of a merchant is not an easy life. Oh sure, we have all the expensive creature comforts, but the nights are awful cold when my husband's away. Okay, up we go. Look at this, it's our latest shipment of special tonics. How about some grated kitty nipple? Or maybe you prefer a fresh ogre wort? Ruby says, I'd prefer that you stop talking about that stuff. I'll be giving you a free jar of hot dragon spew. Now that the cult is straightened up, the shopkeepers have become honest. Can you believe that? Now that Zophar has been defeated, the monster attacks have subsided. Now Nota is even busier with tradesmen from all over the world coming to sell wares. Come in, sit down and relax. My name is Bun, and I'm your hostess, or Bunny. I'm here to satisfy any need that you may have. All I ask is that you leave a big tip. Hero, Ruby says, we better get out of here before you get in trouble. You've come to the right place to relax. Nota's Tavern is the best in the business, world-renowned for its tonics. I've heard through the grapevine that your kitty is not a cat at all. In fact, I heard that she's really a baby red dragon. If that's true, I'll give you everything I own to buy her. What do you think? Ruby says, I think your brain must be donated to science, so we can better understand chronic retardation in the adult female. Get a clue. I'm not for sale, lady. Oh, Ruby. Lamina says, be polite. Didn't you hear? She said she'd give us everything she owns. We'd be rich. Ever since the world was saved, the ladies here seem somehow tamer. I kind of like the old way better, even if we were near destruction. If that makes me a perverse person, devoid of any humanity, so be it. Hey, let's toss back around in honor of the heroes that saved the world. Yeah. It seems like the priesthood of Althina has changed for the better recently. They're less noisy and annoying, preaching a message of peace and love. I think it's more like the message Althina wants us to hear. Now that the world is at peace, how about a nice wad of butt lint? It's quite rare, and some say it wards off the undead. My god. Like, it probably wards off everything. A few days ago, there was some guy asking a lot of questions about the ruins. Which ruins, I don't really know. Like, I'm so relieved I didn't join the cult of Althina. They weren't working for Althina, they were working to revive Zophar. I heard that the Dragon Master double-crossed Zophar. Zophar thought he was working for him, but he really worked for Althina. What a cool guy. Who is he? Galleon. And who was he? I have seen the face of an angel beautiful in every respect save one. Unless I was talking about Leo. She is unadorned with delicate flowers to complement her beauty. Buy my flowers and perfect your look, won't you? Pooh, Lumina says. What a complete line of donkey plop. I know a good sales job when I hear one, and that's a beaut. My goal in life used to be ripping off as many people as I could to get rich. That was wrong, and now I'm trying to make amends for what I've done. So look into my eyes, and I'll tell you a secret I just learned. No thanks, Ruby says. I'll give you a bit more time to work on your trustworthiness. One of the favorite sports in Nota is not washing for a whole week, then putting out old clothes from Seattle and heading to the middle of the bridge, where you tie a cord around your ankles and jump off the bridge to fly. The cord stops you before you hit the water, and you spring high into the air. We call it grungy jumping. Ruby says, that sounds fun. Where do I sign up? Ronfar says, Ruby, you can fly already. What kind of a sport is it for you? I just like the not washing for a week and wearing old clothes part. Figures, I'd have to get hooked up with a flying cat that likes grunge. What are the odds of that, weirdo? You are now only one tantalizing step away from Nirvana. Yes, this snack mix is absolute physical and spiritual perfection. In one handy bag. You can have it all in your mouth for only 50 silver. Act right now, and if you buy three, I'll throw in an extra bag free. Free? Jeez, Lumina says. Give me some of that stuff. can I pay you later? Sure, if I can deliver later, too. Sorry, babe. No freeloaders. I needed some money, so I pretended to be a toll guard the other day. I demanded a toll from one of the tradesmen, and he gave me a knuckle sandwich. Ooh, that fist-in-the-face routine smarts. What was I thinking? So I want to get to the circus. But I'm not sure from here. Say, did you go to the carnival northwest of town? Northeast of town? Northeast, okay. And I meant carnival, not circus. Northeast. They're having a party to celebrate the New World Peace. I went there to try out the fortune teller and found her to be pretty accurate. Well, at least more than those retarded jerks on the psychic hotline. I mean, what kind of idiot falls for those money-making ploys, really? I've decided to become a member of the Cult of Althina. I know, it's not a popular choice, but that ship's just too cool. I've got a ride on it, and my only shot on at that is to join them. You think I'll get a chance to ride it soon? Ruby says, probably just as soon as we're done riding on it, sucker. Yeah, last time when we got that question, we didn't have the ship for ourselves. I don't want to go in there. I want to go around. I can't go that way, can I? Okay. I heard from a traveler that came through here that the savior of the world was a gambler that came from the Blue Star. I just don't believe it. Ruby says, I've heard that too. Oh, it's kind of a long and complicated story. Don't ask. The brew here tastes a little bit better in the glow of world peace, don't you think? I heard a legend that humans once saved the world for the goddess Althina. Do you think that can be true? Well, legend or no, at least those Althina cult freaks cleaned up their act. I'm beginning to think the goddess had a hand in cleaning things up. Now that Zophag guy is gone, everybody is a lot nicer. Burp. I get a lot more free drinks now. That Althina is great. I sometimes wonder about the rumors I hear in this place. With all the booze flowing in this place, it's hard to know what to believe. I decided not to open a stall at the carnival north of town. With their business dropping off, I don't see that place lasting too much longer. Busy, busy, busy. I'm always busy. If it's not one thing, it's another. Now I've got to relabel all this wine to say Heroes Special Reserve. Remember he gave us this quest? To deliver bottles or something? Bite into one of these sweet, juicy confections and you'll never go back. Each one is a handcrafted masterpiece of sensory perfection. Ruby says, oh, I'm dying to try these things. Look, I'm drooling puddles. In times of peace, ladies who accent their beauty can achieve anything. Try our luscious new lip moisturizer and color enhancer, won't you? If you eat these rolls like Hero the Famous Warrior did, you'll be just like him. And you can only buy them right here. Ruby says, Hero, we didn't eat those, did we? I gave up being a trapper, and I've decided to become a reporter. Say, did you hear the story of Hero, the guy that saved the world? Lumina says, pardon me, but it seems that your information is quite old. If you're going to be a decent reporter, you have to get hot stories. I'll give you all the hot stories you want, but it'll cost you plenty. My husband always looks forward to my home-cooked meals after a long trip. I like making them for him. Well, that's good. Say, aren't you the ones I met a while ago? Where's the good-looking girl that was with you? I'm sorry, you kind of insulted Lumina, too. Hurry and get your very own scale model of the dragon ship Destiny. Just like the one that Hero used to save the world. Hurry, they're going fast. The members of Althena's cult are just intolerable. Noise, noise, noise. That's all they ever make over in their sanctuary. I'm sick of the lot of them. Since the shrine kooks stopped parading through town, it's been quiet here. Actually, I kind of got used to the noise. It feels weird here without it. Well, that lady right outside is complaining about the noise. It's hard to make a living here because prices are so high. I've actually thought about moving to Meribia lately. Well, Lumina says, I can tell you that you'd be much happier in the historical town of Vane. Excuse me, I can get you into a rent-controlled apartment, for a finder's fee, of course. Yeah. Talk to him? Yeah. My dad got the model of the Destiny for me. I can't believe I have a scale model of the ship that saved the world. Yeah. Now that Zophar has disappeared, trade should start picking up around here. It seems like things have quieted down at the sanctuary across the bridge. The priests even seem less weird. It makes me wonder if I should start going again. Ho, traveler, I'm sure you'll find that Nota is the most convenient town around. We're easy to find and have everything you could want in the way of supplies. Oh, and this one is one of my favorites. It's a Dark God Zophar doll. Put it in water and it grows 100 times its normal size. Isn't that the coolest thing you've ever heard? Ruby says, get that thing away from me, you freak. Northeast. Okay. So we need to make our way back all the way around. And I guess off screen, in there, I'll figure out where the hell the carnival is so I can just guide us there without messing around. And that'll be next episode. Because I think an hour of talking to random people is good enough. Got in a bunch of really easy monster fights. No one leveled up, shockingly enough. I guess we just head northeast from here, but isn't that where we came from? Wish I had the ship with us. Wish I could just call it to us. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop that boogie.